I've done that.
I've never done that.
Let me tell you, that is the easiest.
I have never done that.
For real.
Afadhali niweke tu mbako wa sneeze.
Sometimes when you're sleeping, you're scared, the baby is struggling. You know, you don't even open your eyes. You just stand the baby, you're like, where are you?
And I asked him why. He said, because you might cook me and eat me. Happy, happy
world. My name is Rita, and in this channel I share with you videos about motherhood, lifestyle, travel and food. If you're new to this channel, welcome, and don't forget to subscribe. And if you're already part of Rita's world, keep it locked. So what's happening in Rita's world this week? So guys, this week I am joined by the lovely
Chibambe.
And Miss Rosette,
the girl with the flower, say hi.
CEO of Sorano.
The CEO.
Introduce yourself.
Rosette Mumanyi.
Yeah.
CEO, Sorano Beauty, Sorano Virtual Assistants.
Wait.
Making a debut officially
on Twitter. Me too.
This is gonna be fun.
And so, the common factor is that we're all moms.
Yes.
She is a mom, I am a mom, she's a mom.
Yes.
So it's 3, 2, 1.
Mm-hmm. Actually, it's
in,
three,
that
two, one.
In that order.
Why do I feel like I have the most kids?
Because you do.
So in this video, we're going to share about never have I ever.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's a never have I ever game that we're going to play today. Mm-hmm. And the rules are, If you have, you sip. If you have never, you don't sip. Okay?
Why am I sipping? I'm not even started.
We
are game, so you need to accept your game.
This is gonna be a dope video. If you haven't subscribed to my channel and also to Jemu's channel,
what are you waiting for?
Go to our YouTube handles and subscribe.
And please click on the notification bell so that every time Rita posts a video, you'll be the first one to get. Yeah, you'll be the one to get. Yes.
So what is your handle on YouTube?
Jemutai Chibambe World. World. Yeah, well, because basically it involves traveling, comedy, my babies. Those are my wild.
It is a dope channel. You guys, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, I don't know what you're waiting for.
Oh.
Also subscribe to my channel. So, the first question.
Let me to look at my focus the left. At the question.
No, you know what? No, okay. You're not supposed to look at the question. It's supposed to be like instant.
Alright. Okay? Yeah.
So the first question is, have you ever lied to your kid about time?
Yes.
You don't say yes. You sip. You sip.
Guilty as charged.
Guilty.
Who does it?
I feel like this kid ask too many questions sometimes.
I know. Mom, I want to go outside and play. New sequel.
Exactly. I don't have all that.
But do we lie a lot?
Cheers
to honesty, guys.
When you have 3 children, trust me,
you lie.
You have this conversation.
You're a lying machine.
I've never said okay with 100% no clue.
Okay. That's a scenario.
Can we go to Dubai?
Mom, nikimaliza chakula naweza kula ice cream.
Exactly. Like we lay all the time. You see, I'm getting it.
It saves lives.
And it makes you have peace of mind. Have you ever lost a toy on purpose?
As in hide?
No.
Trash can.
Lost a toy on purpose.
As in trash.
You bought a toy for your child and then you quickly realize it's not a good idea. For example,
I take that back.
You've never?
No.
Are you serious? What did you buy? Hey, would you know it's which is a poo 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 and you quickly regret.
No, I regret when it's too late because
I'm a pee pee nurse. No, no.
I bought them.
Ah, I did. I bought her. A water gun.
No, no, no.
I didn't lose on
you purpose. Guys are missing it.
No, I bought a water gun. And then I realized, no, this was a bad mistake. Due to look what
I do, Shiva. Are you in the video?
Yes, I am.
So
come in and involve douche gun. It's new quail. Like I've done that.
Let me tell you guys.
I regret when it's too late. Because I get home with it. Then the canola is too much.
Yeah.
If by losing you mean I and wait for him to go sleep, then in the morning missing. He doesn't find it.
Then yes,
that was Rick, it goes with me. Yeah, I'm gonna do it 3 times for my thinking because I've done this too many times.
If that's what you mean, then yes, double total.
There, one,
double.
Ah. Guilty!
Somebody's not gonna finish this video, guys.
That, let me tell you guys, that toy goes missing.
It doesn't, it's not even placed in the trash can.
I do the search.
Yeah!
I do the on a search. I'm going to find it in your kitty.
It was not even placed in the trash can.
Okay. No. The next question is, have you ever fought a laughter at your kids? No, how do I put this? Have you ever fought off a laughter? Fought off laughing at your kids?
I have.
No, because they mine is pretty young.
No, like if they say something very funny, but you want to look serious, but at the same time you want to, it's so funny you want to laugh. Have you ever been in that situation?
Skumoja was calling JJ. I don't know if this applies.
These questions are not fair because they're cute.
So I was calling JJ. So akakuja, akamuliza, "Mom, are you eating me?" So I'm like, "Mom, are you eating me? What is that?" Kumbe alikuwa anasema, "Mom, unaniita."
Please.
In English.
Let me give it.
In Swa, "Mom, are you eating me? Unaniita."
Scenario. Ryan, when he was 4, came from school. We were cooking meat. So the boy is running around in the kitchen. So I tell him, "Baba, you cannot be in the kitchen. You know why?" So my natural expectation is he'll say, "I'll get back," which he did. He said, "I'll get back." Then I asked him, "Then what?" Then I expected him to say, "I'll go to doctor and doctor yeah. will." Then I asked him, "What will doctor do?"
Inject me.
I expected him to say, "Inject me." So he looked at the fire, he looked at me, and he said, "Yeah, I know. I don't need to be in the kitchen." Then I asked him, "Why?" He said, "Because you might cook me and eat." It was hilarious.
Trying to laugh.
But it's because it's a serious situation, like I need to actually get him off the kitchen.
Do you think sometimes we like say things and yanafanya mtoto afikirie tunaweza fanya hivyo? Like some I know a story ya mtoi alikuwa amezoea ana susu kwa bed. So the mom told him kisusu tena ndakukata ni ya kususu. So one day the baby susued. Akaenda kitchen akatafuta knife. So akichukua knife, this is serious, it's not funny. Akichukua knife, sufuria ikaanguka. Ati mam nimesususu nilikuwa nataka kukata ndio kiamka. So I think what we say to the baby, it's not funny, by the way, it's not funny. Na umecheka, repent. So imagine that was traumatizing for the baby.
Yeah.
So saa zingine I think tuna go overboard ile anda kumeza wewe, you know.
I think we need to watch what you say to our kids. But sometimes you know you just come out. Mamu
tanimeza.
The next question is, okay, this is so common. If there's one of you who hasn't done it, I don't even know what to say.
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever wiped a kid with spit on your thumb?
This is an African thing, yo. Cheers to Africa. And if you watch out, watoto hata wewe.
And if you haven't, you need to try.
Watch out, watoto.
It's not satisfying.
Wipes for who?
It's an African thing.
Well, what's wiping with the thumb and spit? Me, I pick their noses. I'm like, what is this? Let me see.
Yeah, every mom does that.
Like that.
When they're months old, you've never. Okay, I had a baby who was eczema. Who had eczema growing up. His nose used to be congested. The boy is 3 weeks old. They give you that nose or thing. Not that I didn't.
It doesn't have work.
It, but I had it. I tried. I feel like it's hurting him.
Ah, I have done that.
I done
that. Let me tell you, that is the easiest.
I have never done that.
For real.
I'm finally working to back was his. I've never done that. Never.
You know, she's
a friend. She's wrong.
You're taking a break.
She's wrong.
You're never going to be there to eat. I never.
She was raised by the real OG.
My goodness. Me, I have sniffed those noses.
I have sniffed the nose.
I have done all
and
that.
And the first time I did it, I thought it was yucky, but when I saw relief in him.
Can
I tell you, sometimes when you're sleeping, when I'm scared, the baby is struggling. You know, you don't even open your eyes. You just stand the baby on.
This is traumatizing.
You don't even wake up. Let's continue sleeping.
Imagine a mopa. For once, no longer I'm just come and as a suffocate.
Actually, that nozzle thing, for me, it felt like it was paining him because it comes with a lot of pressure and you can't really measure how much of it you're putting out. And I had a face mold.
Akuna like a pump.
That's the pump.
Actually, I look for a photo and tag it somewhere here so that you know what you're talking about.
So that was recommended by a doctor. I tried it and it wasn't pulling enough. You pull, a little comes out and you're a fast pregnant mother.
And also when you let go, it goes back inside.
When
I learned to pull with my nose, with my mouth.
Let me teach you another easier way to do it. If you don't want to pull the mucus into your mouth, you can blow through one nose and then it comes all of it through the other nose. So if you want to, don't want to do the whole thing, you can just blow one nose, block it completely. All the mucus comes through the other nose. And it comes out a lot. And you sleep much better. The next question is, have you ever googled your kids' symptoms?
Kids? One. Doctor Google, Professor.
Watch out, kids. How to make a man miss you? How to make a man regret losing you? Google knows me by name.
Professor Google.
Oh my gosh. Let me tell you my name.
How to make a man regret losing you. One, go to the gym. Work on yourself.
She's wrong.
It is not only about new activities.
Then you realize it's too much work.
At its late.
Hashtag.
Let me tell you.
Now back on the Google for symptoms.
Yeah.
Not only for me, I'm a paranoid now. I think even Rosette knows that. Like I would Google, when I gave birth to my daughter Taraji, she had it's a stray lymph node. So it is like when my launch happened. So when you touch it, you feel like there's a lump. I ended up at Texas Cancer Center. Ask me how? Google.
What she had?
We will help you.
So apparently, like when they are born, sometimes kids are born with that.
But
it was not cancerous. Oh. We did a scan and everything. Yet it has even disappeared. But you should have seen me. That night I didn't sleep. I was like, then you Google a lymph node on what's the upper collarbone. And then you see all those cancer things on it. You're like, oh my god. Yeah. The next morning I carried my tattoo and went to cancer center because I was like, what is the worst that can happen? You get? So, Dr. Google is not your friend.
It is not.
It's not your friend.
But you will lose sleep. I guess we've all
done that. Yeah. Every mom.
Even you guys who are watching, I know you have done it. Yeah. So, see.
I think it's okay to Google and get an idea.
Yeah.
But what I don't understand is go online seeking for advice from online content.
Ah.
If you Google and you have an idea, seek professional
help. Yeah.
It will clear your doubts and you will get the right
name. Yeah.
Question is, have you ever called your kid the wrong name?
No. Only a mother of three can do that.
So, you haven't?
No.
Are you serious?
No.
Okay, me, I think.
Why am I sleeping? No, hell
no. Let me sleep for 3 times.
Yeah.
Are you sure I'm gonna finish this video? Let me tell you, not even Nati calling them their siblings' name. Have a big peace. I call my son my last born brother's name. My brother's name is Isaac, he's the only brother I have, and my son is also the only son. So sometimes I find myself calling Isaac, you know, instead of Leroy. Or I call Taju, I call Imani Taju instead of Imani. I mean, it happens all the time. Please, you guys, you know these things. What are you going to do? You need
a BA.
Omega 3,
yes.
I need supplements.
Omega 3.
I need supplements. Okay. Have you ever forgotten to pick your kids from somewhere? Anyone wants to tell a story?
No.
Why?
I still have none.
Tell me again. Let me tell you something. Even letting go of my kid, we can sit just for fun.
I'm not sleeping on that one. Amanda's role.
You have to be conscious of where your children are.
It's unfortunate that because of life's pressures, and sometimes you find yourself in situations where it's like you're almost forced to choose between your mother and yeah. There's so many other facets in life.
Yeah, that's true. Being a wife, yeah.
You know, you're trying to balance all these other aspects, and sometimes we drop the ball on the motherhood aspect.
Yeah.
But I think that should always reign supreme. If you forget everything else, just don't forget your mother.
Okay, me, I have never forgotten, but I have wished that the person I gave my kids forgot to call me to go and pick them up.
I don't want it.
When the kids go to her place for sleepover, I'm like, after when I see her phone, I'm like, I hope you're not saying you're coming back. At least give me one more day to at least enjoy it. I'm not saying motherhood is bad.
No, it's okay.
We can skip to that one, because if that's what you mean.
No, I mean,
brought her into your house.
What do you think I call your life?
The house was quiet. I was like, I can actually
sleep
like
wordless. Yeah.
But you're sure that there is good in a good place.
Of course, you have to trust the person.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, but of course you have to trust the person. Yeah. Sleepovers have turned out to be
very ugly.
Yeah,
true.
Ones are in this generation.
Yeah. So, and that is why I think it happens like that, because we rarely do it in as much as we're very close.
Yeah.
But when it happens, like once or twice in a year, you're like,
my kids have never gone to a sleepover.
For real?
I've always slept. I've always been with my kids.
I'm gonna take
them. Not unless I'm demand a job.
Yeah. But you see, at the end of the day, you come back home to me.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It's not like they've ever been away from me.
I don't think I'll sleep well.
Let me tell you, the day you do that, first of all, you walk into the house and you're like, you should not
And you're like 7 points.
What to talk?
Yeah.
You know, when I started sleepovers, I would go with, and this is my very good friend, close friend, best friend.
17 almost years of friendship.
I would
and you cannot trust me with your child.
With your one child.
But I would go with my son for 7 months at her house. As in, motherhood is challenging.
It is.
Letting go is hard.
Yeah.
So even the first time you do it, you probably make several phone calls, if not go with them, you know, until you know.
The next question is, have you ever received unsolicited, is it called unsolicited, parenting advice from a stranger?
Can we just gallop this and please stop?
One day, let me say this from experience. My son was very, very big. I told him, like 8 months.
Mm-hmm.
So tumetoka to my clinic, and I got power down and they take him. You know, 8 months old, when you're mdogo, but very, very chubby.
And then you're a first time mom.
I'm a first time mom. Nikamwekelea kwa counter. Oh, mama, nimefanyisha gym.
At 8 months, ningechukua diaper nimuulizie kwa mdomo.
Niliangalia mimi nikambea. Mtoto 8 months.
You even know the girl's response.
I felt so bad. You cannot say
it's
that.
So
alafu usi ati anakula chips, anakula chocolate, anakula ice cream, anakula ni breastfeeding na. Kama ni food, jo kwa 8 months alikuwa na food, anakuwa nakula ni food natural, boiled, azim.
No fat, no anything.
It was so insensitive. Yeye apeleke mtoto gym. nenda kwa 8 months imagine.
And coming from a woman.
But let me tell you guys. Sometimes, let me tell you. Sometimes as mothers, you give this advice that, like you said,
advice.
We really don't have to. We are doing our best.
Yeah.
Baba.
There's no manual to manage.
Jay, stop running.
What I know, there's no manual to
manage. Come,
come say hi.
Come say hi.
This is the boy you are talking about. Come.
And say hi.
Come say hi. No!
Say hi.
Say hi to the camera. Say hi.
Hi guys.
Say hi guys.
Hi. Oh. Go back. Go.
Okay, go.
Where is my phone? You go watch cartoon.
So like I was saying, one, there's no manual to motherhood or parenting.
Yeah. There's no manual.
Or life.
Yeah.
Everyone is doing the best.
And every mom is a perfect mom.
Every mom is a perfect mom because their first instinct to their child is always right.
Yeah. True.
You're not gonna come out as an outsider and think
you know better
mm-hmm. than the mother
who's
holding their child in their arms.
So keep it to yourself. If you have to correct me about motherhood, let me tell you one thing. You have to be someone who's very close to me to know exactly what I'm going through. That is the only way I listen to you. But if you do not know me, please. I don't want.
Because you body shame to talk, you never do that.
Please.
Yeah. Ah, body shaming kids, body shaming mothers.
At here, you stop me. No, never. Yeah, I tell you. You stop 1 year, 20. Anaka 5.
That's a healthy baby.
Look. Some people are like, okay, you've added so much. Can you think those babies were being carried in my head? They were being carried in my chest.
Are you throwing shit?
Yes. You know yourself. You know yourself.
Everything. Gym intermittent. Drink water, please, women.
I know she
wants
the best
woman,
but still.
Me na jam tutakona mama kona 5 years na nasema, "Hey, get up in here, I'm 5 years."
5 years,
women.
Yeah. Let me tell you, that brings me to the other question.
5 years, but unaekelea mtoto. Hapana lipa jibu bwana.
Leo mama, take your
wisdom. Lipa jibu.
Why
was that? Hey, mtoto wangu ni mdogo 5.
YouTube and stuff like that. If you can use not even half of that, like an eighth of that, to do like 15 minutes every day, that's all you need. But be consistent on a daily routine. Consistency is what most of us love.
Me, when it comes to weight loss, you're talking to me directly, Rosette. But I'm still breastfeeding though.
At least
I'm not even talking about weight loss, but it has got nothing to do with weight loss. Because also, remember, metabolism is different.
So me, my last bone is turning 4 years. But I want to also say this, like, I think when I had my first bone, it was so easy to bounce back. Like, it was like, I had my baby, 6 months later, I was back. The second bone was also the same. Like, once I had my child, after 6 months, after breastfeeding, I snapped back. Watch out, I'll tell you guys the third one.
Let me tell you mine.
Right now, I'm wearing the same weight. I like saying that, by the way. The same weight I was when I was giving birth. And I'm not pregnant. I'm trying.
I need a hug.
I'm trying my best to lose the weight. But
let me say this. You look good for 3, baby.
Aww.
Oh, you do. It is very true. You too. Okay, finally we agree on something.
Yeah. I've thrown shit at you twice. You have not.
We are massaging egos, guys.
You should. Thank you.
But you look so good, baby.
I won't throw shade on you.
Food is my love language.
The next question is, have you ever caught vomit with your hands?
Yeah. But what?
Why
a mommy's things is so.
Have you ever maybe she,
because the before bum, I think your chin and a conga even.
So now
vomit is so
mild.
The bum. Sometimes
so
in the middle of changing
water
or a shower, and then the bum is in action.
Puke is like all the time. When you're feeling the child, you see it coming, the first instinct is like, read here. Yeah.
When you see it coming from the bum, the first instinct
is
It's either either your hands or your couch.
I can actually not say I've done that.
No.
Which one?
There was, it's a rare occurrence. No.
It's a rare occurrence, but it happens.
It happens.
Like
it happens,
there's a running stomach.
Yeah, it does.
You're about to take a bath with the child, you see it coming.
Yeah, you, the one that
you've done your spread over there, but it's cool.
MVP.
Take that back.
See, like I said, you're all moms. I expect
that you take that back.
I take it back. I actually do take it back. But on that note, have you, like you have a boy? You have a boy, I have a boy. Have they ever peed on you like when you're changing them?
Let me give you this story. I was doing exams, maybe. My bro was sitting in for me.
Drink!
I did. So my bro was sitting in for me. Obviously, I had a nanny, but I was on maternity, so I wasn't comfortable with the children. So I come back, doing exams. And I see a letter away from the entrance. It's like the depth is the one which was leading me where my son is.
Hold. Speak up.
Then I can't see my bro. I'm only seeing the boy, my son, on the couch with the two legs.
Kicking,
no diaper. Mm-hmm. So I go and finish up the wrapping of the diaper and everything. Then I see my bro coming from the like he has had the doorbell, but he's not sure who walked in. I'm like, what are you doing? You left the boy alone. The boy peed on my head. So I have to shampoo my head.
He's so lucky he peed on his head. He's peed on his mouth.
Like, it was hilarious.
That was hilarious. So.
So guys, this brings us to the end of our Never Have I Ever Q&A.
Yeah,
we've had an awesome
Mom's
time. Mom's edition. We had an awesome time with Devuta.
Hi guys, bye.
And my girl Lizette. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe. Also, don't forget to subscribe to Jemutai's YouTube channel. And also head on to Instagram and what is it called? Follow?
Sorano Beauty.
Sorano Beauty.
Yeah.
She's the owner of Sorano Beauty. So this is
Instagram.
God power.
Women who support women.
All the way. So if you like
Thank you for having me, Rita, on your channel.
It's been a pleasure. I've always watched you on Tasha. Even my girl. Like, I've been watching you. She's such a pleasant girl to hang out with. It is such an honor. And also, my best friend Rosette making her first debut on my video today. I think we should do another video.
More often.
Yeah, we should do this more often. It was so much fun. So, thank you guys for watching. I hope you learned something and I hope you also had fun throughout this video.
We hope you sipped.
Yes. Sip on whatever it is you're sipping.
Give us feedback down below.
On the comment section.
Sip on whatever you're sipping.
Yeah.
Who do you think sipped the most? Who do you think sipped the most?
I'm not mentioning names. I'm just
sipping. Okay, that's it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching our video and see you in our next video. Okay? Bye.
Bye.